What's up, game developers? CouchFerret here, and welcome back to Shooting Arrows Part 2. Today, we'll continue our script to shoot arrows in any direction, rotate them to match the direction, and destroy them after 2 seconds. If it sounds fun, then stay with me and consider subscribing so you won't miss any future videos of this game. Cool, let's begin! In part 1, our arrows only flew to the right, so let's change that and have them fly in any direction. Let's open up our player controller script, select the whole shooting part and move it into the move crosshair function. We only want to let the players shoot when they aim as well. To make it clear, let's rename the function to aim and shoot and also change the call in the update function. Now we need to change the vector we use to set the arrow's velocity. Instead of having it fly in a constant direction, let's create a shooting direction vector 2 variable for that. This variable's value should be similar to the aim variable's value, but in 2D. Before we use it, let's normalize it to make it 1 unit long, so the arrow's speed is always 1 whether we push the joystick fully to the side or not. Now we can change the constant vector we've used earlier to shooting direction. Let's test it. They are definitely slow. Let's make them faster by multiplying the shooting direction by 3. That's better. Okay, let's move forward with the arrow's orientation, which is a bit trickier. Somehow we need to derive the angle of the rotation from the shooting direction vector. Luckily, Unity has a MathF collection with an 8on2 function in it. This 8on2 function gives us back an angle between the x-axis and the 2D vector starting at 0 and terminating at the given x and y coordinates. Using this, we can get the angle between the shooting direction and the x-axis, which we can use to rotate the arrows counterclockwise. Let's try the function out first. Be sure to pay attention to the order of the function's arguments. The first argument is the y coordinate, and the second is the x. If you mess it up, it measures the angle from the y-axis instead of the x-axis. If we give it the 1 and 0 vector, which is the direction to the right, then it will give us 0, meaning the angle between the x-axis and the vector is 0. That's true because they are the same direction. Let's give it the up direction, which is the 0 and 1 vector. It gives us back a value of 1.57, which is nowhere near the 90 degrees that we expected. The problem is that the 8on2 function answers our calls in radian, which is a pi-based measurement, but we need degrees. To convert the angle in radian to degrees, we need to multiply the value by matf.rad2dig. This is a constant value which converts radian to a degree. Okay, now let's rotate our arrows. The z-axis is the one which goes into the screen, so we need to rotate the arrows around that. Transform.rotate is a function which rotates a game object around the 3 different axes. Let's type arrow.transform.rotate 0 and 0. The first two arguments are zeros because we rotate around the z-axis. The third argument is mathf.8on2 shootingdirection.y and shootingdirection.x multiplied by mathf.rad2dig, which is our previous calculation. Let's try it out. Now all the arrows' orientations are correct no matter what direction we fire in. However, as we can see in the hierarchy window, the arrows we've shot remain in our scene and slow down our game. We need to get rid of the ones that have already left the screen. Luckily, Unity has a destroy function with a timer in it as well. Let's type destroy arrow and 2 to destroy the arrow game objects 2 seconds after we've shot them. Now, it doesn't matter how many arrows we shoot. Eventually, all of them will be destroyed to free up the computer's resources. One last thing I wanted to do today is to change the button for the firing action. Currently, it's set to the A button, but it's quite a hassle to reach when aiming with the right stick. So let's change it to the right trigger. I use Rewired, which is a paid Unity asset to handle controller inputs, so it's very easy to remap the inputs. At the joystick maps, we need to set the Fire Actions button from Action button row 1 to right shoulder 2. It's much more comfortable. Cool! That's it for today, folks. Next time, we will draw pixel art shooting animation in A-Sprite. We will create it in all 8 directions to make smooth turning transitions. So be sure to subscribe and leave a thumbs up. If you have any questions from today, feel free to ask and I try to answer all of them. See you next time!